we live in a ever small world, smaller and smaller.
当今世界我们住的这个就是这个范围变得越来越小。
Composers in the West are always looking for new sounds, new voices.
现在就是西方的一些作曲家们都在寻找一些新的声音，新的音乐。
The flute being such a important instrument in some Asian cultures has had a big role to play in this music.
而笛子对于在亚洲文化来说是一种非常重要的乐器。
So today I bring you just a few examples of what composers living in the West are doing, or composers that have studied in the West.
而今天我给大家展示的就是几首西方作曲家们现在正在进行的一些事情，一些创新，对笛子的创新。
So, what we call compositional synthesis is when a composer has explored all their possibilities, or they think that they have explored all possible sound making, they start incorporating other sounds from other places.
就是这里主要的概念就是综合，综合的意思就是指作曲家们在探究一切的可能性。他们在融合各种不同的曲子进行创新。
There is many ways to do this, and inspired by philosophy or religion, they can use a number of tools.
综合关于综合有非常多的不同的方法，比如说在哲学还有宗教方面也有一些融合，他们的融合的方式都不一样。
I'm just going to talk about a few of the techniques that they use, a few of the tools, but keep in mind that these are just a few of many.
现在我们就来主要看一下其中的几种方式。
Okay, yes. Alright. So, Tim Honda is a very young composer who is living now in the United States.
陈宏大是一位非常年轻的作曲家，他现在住在美国。
He's the newer generation of composers, but he has a very special talent of making extraordinarily fabulous pieces with very little material.
他就是有一种非常高的技巧，他可以用一些非常少的材料，然后用一些非常高的技巧来进行创作。
He wrote a piece for me called Conversations Between Wind and Water.
他为我写了一首曲子，叫做《风与水的对话》。
It's inspired by the Taoism's belief of nature being a powerful force.
这首曲子的灵感是来自于道家的一种思想。
And he uses a number of very simple sounds. There's three sounds that you see there to represent wind and to represent water.
他用了非常不同的声音来模仿风的声音和模仿水的声音。
It's a very literal.Interpretation.
这是一种单纯粹的模仿，对声音的模仿。
So, the first sound sounds like this.
风的声音是这样子的。
Very simple.
非常的简单。
最后一个音，
最后
的，
最后一个降 A。
I just played the first line. Where's the
trailer?
So you can just an example.
He wants you to finish the first line.
The first line? Oh, okay. Good, good, good. Goes on. It keeps on going. Un so vita. And so forth. And so forth. The next cell is a little different.
接下来的这个声音有点不一样。
By blowing very, very, very softly in the flute, you get very, very high but very soft notes.
就是我会吹一些非常的柔和的声音，也可以吹一些非常的重的声音。
You might not be able to hear it in this room. think you can hear it. 可以听吗？可以听。
这是最后的第二行。
Okay. Water sound. It's very different. The wind sounds are very shallow. The water sounds are very deep by using a special technique called tone ram. Tone ram. I'll explain what it is.
水的声音是跟风的声音是完全不一样的。风的声音它比较浅，但是水的声音它也很深。
It sounds like this.
听起来是这样的。
A little lower when the fluid is in the mouth.
比较声音听起来比较低沉。
So, with these two very different techniques and with different variations on it, it makes a very, very beautiful and very interesting piece.
这两种不同的演奏技巧就是一起结合，就是使这首曲子非常的与众不同，非常的好听。
Jian Guan Chang uses pretty much the same inspiration, but in a much more complicated way.
张仁矿他的创作技巧有点复杂。
He's not just a composer of acoustic instruments, but he also does a lot of things with video and with electronic music and computer generated images like the one in the painting.
他不仅仅是对平时的一些声音进行创作，他而且他还进行一些电脑的对声音进行一些电脑的合成。比如说我们接下来讲的就是一首电脑合成的曲子。
He's very very creative, and especially in the electronic music circles.
他非常的有创造力，尤其是在电子音乐这一块。
That's more good. His piece is much more complicated, also inspired by Taoism.
这首曲子也是非常的比较复杂的一首曲子，它也是它的灵感来自于道家思想。
There's more and more varieties and much more aggressiveness. This is an exploration of nature being very powerful and man being among inside.
就是这首曲子它不单纯是通过模仿声音和模仿声音来形成的，它还是表达一种人类自身的一种情感。
If you look in letter J, there's a certain technique.
大家看到这里有一个字母叫 J.
对 J.
这里的一种技巧非常的特别。
好吧，那是风 ，right? It's wind, right?
这是对风的模仿。
Always very aggressive.Aggressive, very angry.
表达是一种愤怒。
But there's a human factor within this, which is there's song and play, like the first line.
同样的，它这里也表达了一种人类对自然的一种感觉，比如说第一行这个谱子。
But nature is unpredictable.
大家都知道自然是不可预测的。
There's a primary line on top, and there's a secondary line in the bottom.
大家看这个谱子，它第一行是最基本的旋律，然后它还有一个 secondary part， 就是即兴创作的部分。
So there's these arrows there.You see these arrows. Tell them about the arrows.
大家看一下那一部分。
Within this line.
在这一行。
I insert each of these cells. These are individual cells.
就是在他刚刚指的那些虚线的地方，他可以随根据自己的即兴创作加入下面的那些那些部分。
One of these cells is a line of the very famous poem.
其中一个部分就是来自于一首非常有名的诗歌。
That way he expresses variability. It's every time the piece is different, and it's different from performer to performer.
这首曲子它的意思就是，其实每首曲子它都是不一样的，你随时随地都可以进行即兴创作。
好吧 ，next, very good. Peter Kosygi is a Hungarian composer living in Berlin.And his inspirations are different. These are not now Asian culture per se, but from a little different Western perspective.
Peter Kosygi, 他是一个匈牙利人，他现在住在德国的柏林。他的音乐也是非常的与众不同的，他的灵感来源于希腊神话以及一些宗教。
Let's go to the piece already. Great. His piece, It's supposed to represent a very old Chinese ritual, ancient, before history.
接下来这首曲子是他的一首非常有名的作曲，它主要表达的是一种中国非常古老远古时期的一种礼仪礼节。
He uses electronics to provide the background, the lower line, the lower line. This is electronic generated.So it represents drum beats.
他刚刚指的第二行就是电子合成的音乐。这个音乐它的节奏表达的是一种鼓的声音，鼓的节奏。
In order to produce the desired effect, he asked the performer to play in a Chinese bamboo flute.
由于它的音高是非常不同的，所以他使用了一种中国的笛子来演奏这种高度。
But he asked for very interesting techniques, like this one here.
他使用了一种非常特殊的技巧。
And also to sing and play at the same time.
就是在弹奏的同时还能唱出来。
This technique called chevrotter sounds like this.
刚刚他说的就是那种演奏的技巧，演奏的名字，技巧的名字。
什么说 goat? Goat. 羊。以后later he asked for voice, right?Later, he asked for vibrato in the hands. Vibration in the hand. Vibration.
接下来他会通过指法的变化来一些技巧演奏。
So, not a pretty diz, an ancient diz.
它跟当代的笛子不同，它是一种演奏的是一种古老时期的一种笛子的技巧。
This melody, no, this piece has no melodies.It's very, it's all phenomenon. It's very improvised, very, very unconstructed, you know, very, spontaneous.
这首曲子它没有一个稍微没有旋律，它全部都是即兴的一种自发的一种创作。
Nice. Good. Anthony Derides, it's a good friend of mine.
接下来这位作曲家是我的一个好朋友。
He wrote this piece for me, and I premiered it 2 years ago at the Central Conservatory.
这首曲子是他为我写的，是两年前在中央音乐学院写的。
He has written for a lot of Asian instruments and for a lot of virtuosos like Meng Xiaofen and Wu Man.
他为许多亚洲琵琶天才写过曲子，比如说明晓峰和吴蛮。
He works a lot with electronics. Next.
它同样的也跟电子伴奏进行过合作。
He uses a special software called Digital Performer.
他使用一种非常特殊的软件，叫做 Digital Performer.
He recorded small pieces, very small notes from an 二胡。
他对一首非常短的二胡进行了录音。
This is all the arhu sounds, normal arhu sounds.
下面那个窗口是指一些非常正常的二胡的声音片段。
He then places them in this program, and he stretches them or clips them, sometimes turns them around backwards.
他把这些片段就是进行改变，比如说拉长或者缩短，或者音调调高或者调低，就如上面那个窗口所展示的那样。进行变化调整。
It's a timbre, let me put it this way. It plays with the same notes of the arhu and the flute. Sometimes they mix.
就是在这首曲子中，二胡的声音和二胡伴奏的声音和长笛的声音是同个水平的。
I'm gonna play the first movement, and I'm gonna point so that I can show you more or less what's happening. You can hear it, and you can see how this performance.
我将给大家展示一下这首曲子经过改制后的这种合奏。
预备。There's more, obviously. Shirish Korde, it's an Indian composer, born in Uganda.
接下来这位作曲家，他是一位印度作曲家，他出生于乌干达。
He has written a lot of works, not only inspired by Indian music, but also by Japanese music and by music from Sumatra, Java, etc.
他写过许多的曲子，他的灵感不仅来自于印度，而且取材于日本。
He also mixes instruments in a very particular way. Let's go.
他的演奏技巧也是非常的独特的。
I apologize. The transcription. This is the Hindi, supposed to be the Hindi translation, but it didn't.
就是个长方形的那个东西，其实显示的应该是一个印度的字。
Anusvara, it's a letter in some Hindi languages, and it's produced by the nose.
Anusvara, 它是一个字母，它是一个延音，就是在印度半岛那一块地方，他们语言中经常会有的。
So it's usually very short, and it's like, probably a small example, not a good example, is Om Mani Padme Hum.
对，就是这种鼻音 ，Om Mani Padme Hum 这种鼻音。
But it's also used in some meditation. It's also used in some meditation to align. To align the body, basically, to align the body.
就人们通常在沉思的时候会发出这种声音。
Based on this, he wrote the piece. Next.
基于这个音，他写了接下来的这首曲子。
He provides a drone, which is very typical in Indian music. A drone, a note that keeps on going and going and going.
这首曲子中他使用了一个非常特殊的乐器，就是会产生一些延音，一直不会动的一种延音。
And he writes a raga, which is an Indian scale. He writes it for the performer. He writes it out completely.
他这首曲子采用的全是一种 raga 音阶，一种印度音阶。
The drone, this very long line, is usually produced by this instrument called a tambura.
就是这种延音，它是由叫做 tambura 这种乐器所产生的。
It's very big. It's very hard to travel with it. So the Indians have invented the ragini box.
这种乐器它的体非常的大，所以呢它不方便携带，人们呢就根据它发明了一种它的电子版本。
Hosokawa Toshiro is a very popular Japanese composer that studied in Europe for a long time.
接下来这位作曲家，他是一位非常有名的日本作曲家，他在欧洲也待了很长的时间。
He stood among other people with the very famous Lee Sang-yoon, a Korean composer of very big renown.
他的老师是一位韩国有名的作曲家伊桑。
His inspirations for his works are based on Shinto religion and also Chan Buddhism. In this case, Zen Buddhism.
他的作曲灵感来自于一种宗教 Hindu religion， 还来自于一种成佛教。
Okay, next. He uses the modern flute to imitate the shakuhachi.
他使用一种非常现代的笛子来模仿日本一种古老笛子的声音，叫做尺八。
And just like a beautiful Japanese painting or a Japanese calligraphy, you see a lot of sparsity plus a very dramatic brushstroke work, and it's represented by very pleasant lines that are interrupted by.Something very strong, very solid.
就是这种，它的采用的曲子就跟比如说日本的一些漫画、一些书法，还有一些绘画中间使用的东西一样，就进行一种结合。
So, Among these attacks is the very popular shakuhachi technique called muraiki, or attack without tongue, with a very strong gust of wind.
在这种技巧中有一种非常特别的技巧。
Even right, very noisy.
听起来会非常的感觉非常的吵。
Very nice, not clear, not very very dramatic, very upsetting.
听起来非常的吵，就是不太清晰。
Finally, he asked the flute players to do something very unusual, which is make sound while inhaling, while breathing in.
他还使用了一种非常特别的技巧，就是在吸气的时候进行演奏。
Flute players are used to breathe in very quickly.To keep the line going, so it takes a certain practice to learn how to breathe slowly in.
所以他这种通过吸气演奏的技巧是非常的难的，所以长笛家们通常会进行专门的训练。
In this first bar, is exhaling. The second bar has a narrow up, means inhaling. The second bar has exhaling, vibrato, and then inhaling again. The line is never broken that way.
这种沿线是指的在一段内它是吸气，一段内它是呼气，这种呼吸它是不间断的。
There's also singing and playing like I did before.
还有一种技巧就是在弹奏的同时还可以唱歌，唱出声音来。
And also blowing so strongly that you can hear the overtone harmonic series.
还有就是通过改变吹气的强度来发出一系列的和音。
I'm just gonna play the overblown at this point. I'm gonna just play this part.
我将给大家演奏的是这种 overblown 这个部分。
These are just a few examples.There's many more, but these are pretty wide examples of how composers are using Western techniques and thinking to incorporate into new music.
我给大家展示的这些曲子只是其中的一小部分，其实还有很多很多这种新的曲子。在那些新的曲子中，西方可以展示西方作曲家他们是怎么引用新技术进行创作的。
谢谢你们。Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
还有问题吗？
这个题目很有意思。对于无论是对于作曲家来说，还是表演这个演员来说，都是很有意思的一个话题。我来跟这个于老师说的，以后我们专门
再有再多找几个人来探讨这个问题。
好，谢谢，
没事。
好，那我们是